To start off, we really have a couple of pillars of therapy for clear cell RCC. Clearly, anti-angiogenic agents, particularly VEGF-TKIs, are a pillar of RCC therapy. And immunotherapy, particularly with anti-PD-1 based agents, is a second pillar. But we really lack a firm pillar after that. mTOR inhibitors are, they have some role, particularly in combination like everolimus and lenvatinib, but their efficacy is really lacking. And so we really need another strong pillar. And there's at least a hope that HIF-2 alpha inhibitors, really a novel target in clear cell RCC, could be another one of those pillars. I think it's still early. I think the initial trial data is very, very encouraging. I think the ongoing phase III will be very, very telling. And then the next question will be is if they're really the phase III trial confirms that this is a potential pillar, meaning it really does have efficacy in clear cell RCC, how can we actually utilize this more effectively by either moving it earlier or by using it in various combinations? And we are seeing that already early on with early trials of cabozantinib plus belzutifan, but thinking in the future, well, what are other combination strategies we can utilize? At the same time, though, I think it's worth noting the limitations. One is, we don't have that big phase III efficacy results yet, and so that's going to be a key factor. But second is there's already mechanisms of resistance that we're seeing emerge in this targeted approach, either through mutations in HIF-2 alpha itself, which can prevent the binding of belzutifan or MK-6482, or actually mutations in the partner in HIF-1 beta or ARNT, which actually increases the affinity of this complex. So even in the presence of this drug, it's just not enough to stop this complex from having downstream effects. And so knowing that resistance mechanisms are already possible, it's important to start thinking about what are other ways to effectively target or degrade HIF-2 alpha to overcome these potential mechanisms of resistance.